Mason Boyne on the march once again. Mason Boyne and his bold orange men, with the shake of the hand and the kick in the groin. Mason Boyne, Mason Boyne, Mason Boyne.
For goodness sake, hurry it up, Morag, will you? I've got a very important meeting tonight. We're going to discuss the three most important issues facing mankind in the world today. Nuclear disarmament, a starving third world, and the growing number of Catholics in Edinburgh.
The Jesuits are all right.
What, then next door, the Papists? They are not all right, and don't you forget it.
Well, it was Therese that gave me a loan of some milk for your tea tonight.
Oh, it's Therese gave it to you. What? Did you know it was for me? They probably blessed it by the priest before they gave it over.
No, they're all right.
All right, they are also rabid Romans. There's nothing to do with them.
How do you mean?
How do I mean? It's obvious, isn't it? It's all there in the history books. I mean, take Poland, for example. Take Poland. There's a country with a predominantly Catholic population, right? What is Poland most famous for? Eh? Ask yourself. In 1937, they let the Germans march straight in, thus allowing the Second World War to happen. And I'll tell you something else. Did you know that Adolf Hitler was a Catholic? And Mussolini, and Attila the Hun, and Dracula, and, by the way, that huge shark that ate all the people in Jaws. You get what I'm talking about now, Morek?
You're saying the Pope's a fish?
No, Morek, I'm not saying the Pope's a fish. I am simply saying that my hatred and my total distrust of Roman idolaters is based entirely on historical facts.